Greetings, unsettled souls. Welcome to the correct news. Sam IB doing political commentary for the media speaks and giving a shout out to all the people who have hit subscribe recently. I want you to do me a favor, even if you haven't subscribed, which you can take this opportunity to do. I need you to do me a favor. I need you to politely, the operative word here is politely, if you have ever liked one show that I've ever done, or if you've ever hated one so much that you just came back to hate it again, do me a favor. Politely, tell the GOP convention on their website. You can contact them. You can also call Mr. Priebus. His number is on the site. Politely, leave one, not many, one message saying, why didn't you make room for the correct views? Because I have contacted all the proper press agencies that I needed to for an independent media pass. I have the following, thanks to many of you for it. I have covered other major events, Bilderberg being one of them, and they said they were full. Well, how is it they picked everybody else other than me? So I want you to do me a favor. I want you to help me here. I don't want your money. Well, you can donate if you want. That'd be helpful. But what I need you to do very much is to contact the GOP and say, make room for the correct views. And I'm going to keep calling them and letting them know that I have listeners that are really upset that I didn't get in this. Now, I need you to be polite, okay? Don't be a jerk. You're not helping me if you're a jerk, okay? But if you're on my side here, make it known, make it loud. I would greatly appreciate that. Friends, here's what I got. Breitbart.com. Some of the most awesome people that I've ever run into on a comment line are from Breitbart. I love Alex Jones, but they're much more polite on Breitbart. Iran's Khomeini, U.S. can't do a damn thing to curb the missile program. Now, I'm going to go to screen share through most of this because I'm on location right now. Let me explain to you why this bothers me so much. It's not because I think that America necessarily has the right to tell people how to run their own country. I have been on record for saying quite vocally that this idiot is building a nuclear power plant on a known fault line, which is going to create a Fukushima-like event in Iran. And all four of the meltdowns at Fukushima were not caused by the earthquake, but we know for sure that one would have happened without the tsunami. That's very important. Possibly two. And the problem with that is if an earthquake can trigger a tsunami, and the earthquake of an equal magnitude is expected to hit that region within the next 25 to 40 years, which is the lifespan of a nuclear power plant, then they are building it in a death trap. Okay, they keep talking about how much they hate Israel. You could have a million angry Jews with pretty locks and bagels, and I promise you they would not kill as many people as this power plant is going to. Yes, I said it. The problem goes beyond that, though. This guy signed a deal. Now, I don't care if maybe he wishes he hadn't. Nobody made him do it. He signed a deal to not test weaponry that could be equipped with nuclear technology in return for billions with a B of your money, you listening to this, your tax dollars. You paid for this. He signed an agreement and he lied. That is the point here. It doesn't matter if you hate America. I'm listening to this in whatever country and I hate America. That's fine. You don't sign the deal then. You don't sign the deal and then lie. Iran's Ayatollah Ali Khomeini says that the U.S. and other Western powers failed, and God willing, they will continue to fail, to rein in the nation's missile program. In other words, they're bragging about being liars. You can always trust them, the religion of peace. Iranian Supreme Leader Ali Khamenei on Monday said that the United States cannot do a damn thing about the Islamic State's ballistic missile program. And people ask why we're voting for Trump. They have engaged in a lot of hue and cry over Iran's missile capabilities, but they should know that this ballyhoo does not have any influence and they cannot do a damn thing, Khamenei said. According to semi-officials at the Qatar's news agency. It says that Iran in March tested ballistic missiles against their words, so of course they're trustworthy, including two with words, Israel must be wiped off of the earth, emblazoned on them, according to the U.S. and other Western powers. Buried in this article, as if you're an idiot, under a nuclear deal signed last year between world powers and Iran, notice it says willingly, ballistic missile tests are not forbidden outright, but are not consistent with the United Nations Security Council resolution for 2015, U.S. officials say. I say we take the damn money back and tell them that that's not consistent with working with liars. And that is something that Trump has advocated, and it's one of the things I like about him. He's got faults. Yes, he has a lot of faults. For one, he's going to be the death knell of the Fourth Amendment. But we don't have a Fourth Amendment now, so it felt like he can do it much harm. He's wrong about Snowden. I think he's wrong about waterboarding. I'm not against torturing terrorists, but the problem here is you don't know whether or not you actually have the terrorist. If you happen to screw up, you damn near drown somebody for nothing. And I don't bend that far. If it's known, I can bend that far. But Guantanamo ended up being an abuse factory, and it was abusing people that had not harmed anyone. So, yeah, I think that that's dangerous. Don't ask me why my screen share is not growing insane, but we'll try it again. We've got Muslim scholar. This is from Paul Joseph Watson, PJ Dub. I can't do the kind of English accent that Paul Joseph Watson does. I can only do the one that sounds like this, and I probably don't do it very well. Paul Joseph Watson video, Muslim scholar celebrates extinction of blue-eyed, blonde-haired Germans. This is like a reverse Hitler. I've never seen anything like this. Literally, I think Michael Snyder used the phrase Hitler in a headscarf. That's what this is here. Islamic scholar Lamia Kadar, yeah, scholar, like from a madrasa, said on German television that being German in the future will not mean having blonde hair and blue eyes, but being a Muslim migrant and wearing a hijab. Now, I'm not in favor of this, and I hope no one actually does this, but what if someone were to have said, I look forward to the death of brown-skinned people in Iran, and I look forward to the day that they all have blonde hair, blue eyes, and little mustaches. Don't you think that might have been a bit hateful? What the hell is this guy called a Muslim scholar for? That's like calling Stalin a philanthropist. Listen, it says, note how the German audience applauded the eradication of their own people. Because supporting the extinction of your own race is far less of a burden than, God forbid, being called a racist. Kador was responsible for publishing the first German translation of the Quran for children and adults. She also introduced Islamic education in German in public schools. This was a huge success, and it led to five of her students traveling to Syria to join ISIS. So she's considered a scholar. She's a scholar. She's teaching people how to blow each other up. Leftists and Muslims celebrating the demographic suicide of a nation is the common theme here. Green Party politician Stephanie von Berg said that it was a good thing that Germans would become a minority in major cities. Germany has definitely had its holes. You can even go beyond Hitler. World War I, they didn't deserve the Treaty of Versailles, but they were not the nicest of people in World War I. But Germany has also carried, usually, the flag of Christianity. And they have always been, while a very progressive society, like you have like swinger bars and stuff, they made sure that the society as a whole still knew that there was somebody upstairs. That's going to be taken away with a religion that is openly advocating, in many instances, the killing of people who are not Islamic. And you can't tell me that the two are equal. Well, you got to give equal say to everybody. No, if someone's an idiot, you don't give them equal say. Muslim Imam Sheikh Mohammed Ayed, such idiot, also gave a speech in which he asserted that Muslims should use the migrant crisis to breed with European citizens and conquer their countries by taking advantage of the fact that Europeans have lost their fertility. Europeans have not lost their fertility. They've just gone a little bit overboard on birth control. They bought into the eugenics lie. I mentioned this in my movie that I made with Christelle, the Bilderberg, Why It Mattered to me. a protester there had quoted this, and I looked it up, and it was true. If you took everyone in the world and gave them an area to live in that was roughly the size of New York City, like what the average person in New York City has, you could fit everyone in the world comfortably into Texas. Okay, we do not have too many people in the world. We have people poorly placed. And as Bill Gates said rather poorly, when once a nation becomes well off, it tends to have less children. So it's not a matter of suddenly they weren't able to have kids, as this is worded. Leftist German politician Gregor Jaycee implied that Germans who oppose the migrant influx, keep in mind there's massive rape going on through Germany right now, were Nazis, and that it was good that Nazis did not have children. So if you don't want your women raped, you are a Nazi. It speaks for itself, friends. We're going to move on. Trump hires a libertarian for his campaign. This is very good news because how many people, leave a comment for me here, how many people agree with me on this? The Libertarian Party is not very good at stopping outsourcing. And I have voted for Libertarians more often than I voted for anyone else. I've never voted Democrat, thankfully. There's a problem here. The giant sucking sound that Ross Perot alluded to, the jobs leaving in droves, the Libertarian Party is letting us down terribly here, and it's why, unless Trump chooses an idiot like Chris Christie, I'm not voting for Twisty Christie, unless he picks an idiot like that as a running mate, I'm probably voting Trump over Johnson. And I voted Johnson last time. I even interviewed his VP candidate for a half hour. He was a great man, Jim Gray. I'm probably going, is a great man, he's still alive. I worded that poorly. I'm probably voting for Trump. And a lot of it is based on my hatred for NAFTA. Well, I think Trump knows he has a lot of lost libertarians hanging on by a thread because there are things about him that really irk us. Well, Kit Daniels writes this, Trump hires libertarian for campaign. Former Rand Paul poster toner for Tony Fabrizio. He hired him. Why do articles always feel the need to repeat the first paragraph twice? I freaking hate that. Trump brought Fabrizio on board after consulting with his new convention manager, Paul Manafort, who absorbed many of the duties previously handled by Corey Lewandowski, who was, of course, framed by that crazy Fields woman. Lewandowski, on the other hand, wanted to hire Ted Cruz, former pollster Kelly Ann Conway. But Fabrizio, whose sources describe as a street fighter with a healthy obsession for winning, has years of experience as a political and corporate strategist who specializes in quantitative opinion research. He also has experience in addressing government waste, and his 2008 study, that's the year of the crash, my friends, showing the average Massachusetts voter believes that the state wastes 41% of its funding. Nice to know we're working for nothing. Fabrizio, like Trump, has also been targeted by the establishment media for injecting libertarianism into the GOP. Thank God. In 2014, the National Review accused Fabrizio of misrepresenting the NSA's dragnet surveillance of Americans with his poll questions. But their accusations backfired given the comments from readers. Besides working on the Rand Paul campaign, Fabrizio worked with Kentucky's Governor Mitt Bevins in 2015. That was a win. And advisor for the Senate for Florida Rep. Ron DeSantis, a libertarian-leaning Republican, which means Paul-like. DeLake, on the Media Speaks, has predicted that we are going to see a Trump-Paul ticket. Now, it's good, but the frighteningly good thing, I should say, about DeLake is he called the rise of Donald Trump when Donald Trump was in the bottom of the polls. He predicted the fall of the shirtless president, O'Malley. He predicted that Bernie would not drop out. He predicted that Cruz would. He predicted that Bush would crash no matter how much money you gave. DeLake's been right about everything since it started. He's predicting a Trump-Paul presidency. I do not. I think he's, I don't, I hope so. God, I hope he's right and I'm wrong, because I'm predicting Trump Carson or Trump Herman Cain. I'm the only one thinking Herman Cain. So I can, if that happens, I completely get mad props. Who would I want him to pick? Walter E. Williams or Judge Napolitano? Neither name has been even mentioned. This is from abc.go.com. Emails from Hillary Clinton's IT director at State Department appears to be missing. Now, this was a story that I think 90% of you would gloss right over, and I'm going to tell you why you shouldn't. She never sent any emails whatsoever to her IT guy. While hundreds of thousands of emails are passing through this account, I tell you, here at 4:20 in the morning. That's impossible. There's no way that you would never contact your IT guy. She clearly deleted these or otherwise hid them in other servers. The State Department said today that it can't find Brian Paolino's emails from the time that he served as Secretary of State to Hillary Clinton's senior information technology staffer during her tenure there. Pagliano would have been required to turn over any official communications from his work account before he left government. State Department officials say he had an official email account, but that they can't find any of those records that he would have turned over and continued to search for them. It says the department has searched Mr. Pagliano's email PST file and has not located one that covers the time period of Secretary Clinton's tenure, as State Department spokesman Elizabeth Trudeau said today. It's a couple days ago now, referencing a file format that holds the email. To be clear, the State Department does have records related to Mr. Pagliano, and we are working with Congress in the Freedom of Information Act requests to provide the relevant material. In other words, it's not there, and we don't want to call Hillary Clinton a liar because she may decide to have us die like she killed Vince Foster, allegedly. So we're just not going to say that we think she's lying. Look. I run a tiny little web page for passingtime.biz. Please look it up. I have had to contact our IT guy. I love you, Martine. I have had to contact my IT guy, okay? The Secretary of State, with all of the information that her and Humor would go through. I'm sorry. It's impossible. I have a degree in IMD. It's impossible. Do you hear me? It's impossible that that would be the case. It just is impossible. So don't tell me. That's why I didn't gloss over it, friends. Maddening. I only got a couple stories left. Don't zone out on me. I just want to let you know it's brought to you by Sticker Junkie. I'm sharing it, looking at it. Do me a favor. When you check out, let D-Lake for Preds. That's who is going to be answering your email. The person who's predicting Trump Paul. God, I hope he's right. He has been, friends, he has been. Type in correct views or the correct views on checkout, and you're going to be getting even more of a discount because you listen to this show, which is wise. Minnesota Republic David Blondin, fat activist. I've got two dumb D's today. Exercise and diets are constructs. Now, in case you didn't notice when you tuned in, I could stand to be a few pounds thinner. I'm not like obese or anything, but you know, 5'11-ish, 198. I could lose a few. I'm not out here telling you it's a good idea to just eat as much as you want. Everybody should accept that you have a fat ass and you're probably going to die of sugar, heart disease, or any of the awful things that come to people with a terrible diet. I think it's probably better to eat better than I do, for instance. Well, a self-proclaimed fat activist, Virgie Tavor, promoted the idea that overweight people are an oppressed class at the University of Minnesota, and even had an event called Dispelling Myths, Fat Phobia, and Challenging Social Stereotypes. Yeah, like, if you're fat, you're going to die of a heart attack. The event, there's a link there, held on the International No Diet Day, that sounds like a great idea, on May 6th, was sponsored in part by the university's School of Public Health and its Office for Equity and Diversity. Weight loss is not a realistic goal for most people. Tweet this. Yeah. Hitler was a great man. Tweet this. Just because you ask someone to tweet this doesn't mean it makes any damn sense. Fat activism puts overweight individuals into a category with other groups of people who claim to be oppressed. it puts the blame of being fat on society as a whole instead of the individual. She claimed that 80 to 90% of people who lose weight will regain the weight that they lose while on the diet, and that it is important for people to realize that the body you have now will be the only body that you ever have. That doesn't make any sense. Tavor said diet culture is a tool of white, heteronormative society, that other means white normal people, whatever that means, and declared that exercise and diets are constructs. I told you we had two dummies today. Stay with me. Society, she said, is fat phobic, and fat phobia is a form of bigotry. It is a form of discrimination. And if you don't hire somebody because they're fat, if you beat them up because they're fat, like I used to get in grade school, that's probably not a great idea. That's not what we're advocating here. We're advocating that somebody say, you know what? You're going to die. Trevor harped about discrimination regarding choices in sexual partners, how chairs are designed, and public transportation usage. In other words, if you don't want to screw a fat person, you're racist. In fact, Tavor claimed that fat shaming has made her avoid public transportation during peak hours. No diets, no diets. At no point did Tavor address death caused by heart failure or diabetes. Tavor also failed to mention the fast food industry, instead decrying diet industries and doctors who she does not think are qualified to speak about health. In other words, if you take her advice, you're probably going to die a lot sooner than you should. And that brings us to the dumby of the day, the story that is even dumber than that one. Oh, yes. Let me get our idiot music going here. We're still on screen share. Oh, yes. Beautiful. Here comes. Listen. Beautiful. All right, friends. Pope Francis likens Jesus to ISIS and says Muslims must breed with Europeans. Let's just let this play for him for a minute. Am I calling the Pope an idiot? God forgive me if I'm wrong, but yes, I'm calling the Pope an idiot. The man just compared ISIS, who, in case you don't know, set people on fire in cages, behead people, feed children to their mother, as we have covered here, go on raping rampages, etc., to Jesus Christ, who spared the life of the person who turned him in for crucifixion. Jesus killed himself, for those of you that don't know. I'm sorry, this is blasphemy, and if God calls me to carpet someday for it, I'm sure he'll see why I thought it. In a shocking interview, Pope Francis likened Jesus Christ to ISIS and said Europeans must breed to counter declining birth rates. Now, usually, you know, popes with a little bit of common sense would have just said, we are against birth control, because that's all you would really need to stop what he's talking about, whether you're for or against it. You don't necessarily need to stop taking birth control. Just compare Christ to ISIS and sleep with the men who are raping you in your square. Dear God. Today, I don't think that there is fear of Islam as much, but of ISIS and its war of conquest, which is partly drawn from Islam. Partly? He told the French newspaper La Croix. That's like saying La Croix is partly French. It is true that I'm going to hang myself. It is true that the idea of conquest is inherent in the soul of Islam. However, it is also possible to interpret the objective of Matthew's gospel, where Jesus sent his disciples to all nations, in terms of the same idea of conquest. No, Pope, it is not possible to interpret that objective whatsoever. That is like saying that because you are a human being and Marilyn Manson is a human being and you both speak into a microphone, you guys are somehow comparable. The Pope also said he dreaded hearing about Christians' roots of Europe because to him they take on a colonist overtones, and he called on European nations to integrate Muslim migrants into the continent. They don't want to integrate. They're publicly saying they want to take over. Does he not have a newspaper in the Vatican? This, somebody get him a subscription to something. This integration is all the more necessary today, since as a result of the selfish search for well-being, Europe is experiencing a grave problem of a declining birth rate, he stated. A democratic emptiness is developed. Now let's pause here. What he is calling a selfish search for well-being is the fact that they can't afford to have a lot of children due to the fact that the European nation has, the European Union has destroyed the sovereignty of independent countries and destroyed their economy. Much like not calling for an end to birth control, which again, you can be for or against, but instead of doing that, he thinks you should breed with people of another religion who want to kill you for being your own religion. He can't seem to realize that it might be a better idea to call for an end of the European Union than it is to blame the declining birth rate on greed. This man is the most out-of-touch person who has ever lived. His opinions are stunningly similar to those of top Imam Sheikh Mohammed Ayyid, that's wonderful news, who said that Muslims should exploit the migrant crisis to breed with Europeans and conquer their countries. Notice he didn't say integrate into their countries. No, Mr. Pope, he said conquer, not integrate. There's a difference. You should look that up, too. Somebody get him a dictionary along with a subscription to a newspaper. Europe has become old and decrepit and needs human reinforcement, which, of course, can't be done by eliminating birth control, but must be done by marrying Muslims. They are not motivated by compassion for the Levant. It's possible, and its refugees soon will trample them underfoot. Allah willing, he stated. Throughout Europe, all the hearts are entrusted, or enthused, excuse me, with hatred towards Muslims. They wish that we were dead, but they have lost their fertility. So they look for fertility in our midst. No, they're reporting you for rape. They are not looking for fertility in your midst. It's about as much as Bill Cosby's victims, maybe. That's a story for another day. We will give them fertility. We will breed children with them because we will conquer. Did you hear that, Pope? Conquer their countries, not integrate, not assimilate. Pope Francis also promoted socialism during the interview. A completely free market does not work, he claimed. Markets in themselves are good, but they also require a fulcrum, a third party, or a state to monitor and balance them. In other words, what is needed is a social market economy. And listen to how this closes. Here's what your social economy does for you. It has been estimated, listen to me, Bernie Sanders fans, he's a socialist. It has been estimated that in the 20th century alone, socialism and communism resulted in the deaths of at least 130 million people. There's a link for it. Friends, the Pope has lost his mind, and you are listening to The Correct Views. Sam I.B. DeGangi signing off. Do me a favor. If you're going to go anywhere, make sure you call Change Transportation. They're cheaper and better than Uber. And if you can donate to the show, if you can help me out, I'd appreciate it. TheCorrectViews@hotmail.com. I'll let you know where to send any donations, and all donations go towards a better show. Good night, friends, and God bless.